Welcome to the screencast, How Do I Create My First Web Kiosk? We start in the Document Manager and click on Create a Collection. Here, we will be creating a bookshelf for the organization of all publications. This way, you will never lose track of your publications and always have control over which e-paper will be shown in which web kiosk. To identify the collection correctly, we open the menu on the right and choose Rename Collection. We enter the name and the collection is created. To show multiple topics in the collection separately, for example, different types of documents, the kiosk will have areas which can have unique names. Now, I'll give it a new name and a description. Next, we will add the appropriate documents to our collection. Simply drag and drop the document. I drag the magazine from the list above in the collection window. And done. Next, we will create the web kiosk. Moreover, every Yumpu user can create his or her own web kiosk. This great feature is already available for all free account members. In the menu on the right, I select the option Link Web Kiosk to Collection. A dialog window pops up asking which web kiosk to link the collection to. Since we have not created one yet, we will create a new web kiosk here. We enter the details for our web kiosk. First, of course, its name. Here, for example, Demo Kiosk. Then, we choose the category. In our case, Business and Marketing. In the Domain field, we can control whether the web kiosk can be accessed via a yumpu.com address. Normally, no changes are necessary here. We continue with the language selection. In our case, we keep it as English. In the Kiosk URL field, we enter the internet address under which our web kiosk can be found. Since our demo magazine is called Jump, we choose the URL to be the same. Clicking Save will complete the creation of our web kiosk. Instantly, we can view our result live online. In the list on the right, we click on the Tasks button and select Preview from the menu. This will direct us to our web kiosk. It contains all magazines which we have added. Of course, we can also customize its appearance. We close this view and then click on the Tasks button. Now, we select Edit Design. We have a separate screencast introducing the drag and drop interface, which appears here. We are changing the global appearance of our web kiosk by clicking Select CSS Style. Here, you will find a wide selection of predefined designs. But in this case, I have already created a custom design with CSS. I select the style Jump Design and click on Save and Close. Then, I click the Preview button and the web kiosk appears in its new colors. Of course, you can always change the order of the areas displayed in your web kiosk as well. Let your creativity run free. Yumpu. We change the way people read content.